Today, we are diving into the fascinating world of arbitrage strategy. Arbitrage might sound complex, but don't worry, we are here to break it down into simple terms. This video includes meaning, types, and use of arbitrage strategy. Let us start with the meaning. Arbitrage is essentially the practice of taking advantage of price differences for the same asset or security in different markets. Let's say you find a product selling for $50 in one market and $70 in another. By purchasing it from the cheaper market and selling it in more expensive one, you can pocket the price differences as profit. There are 5 types of arbitrage strategy. Number 1. Spectacle arbitrage. Spectacle arbitrage involves taking advantage of price differences in different geographic locations. Let's say you find that the same product is priced lower in one city compared to another. You could buy the product in the cheaper city and sell it in the more expensive one for a profit. Number 2. Temporal arbitrage. Temporal arbitrage focuses on exploiting price differences that occur over time. Consider the stock market. Stock prices fluctuate throughout the trading day. Let's say company X announces positive earnings after the market closes. You anticipate that the stock price will rise when the market opens the next day. So, you buy the stock before the market closes and sell it when the price increases, making a profit from that time differences. Number 3. Statistical arbitrage. Statistical arbitrage involves using mathematical models to identify and exploit pricing inefficiencies in financial instruments. Imagine you are analyzing two stocks in the same industry that historically move in tandem. However, due to market fluctuations, one stock price drops more than the other. You could short sell the overpriced stock and buy the underpriced one, betting that the price will eventually converge, allowing you to profit from this spread. Number 4. Merger arbitrage. Merger arbitrage, also known as risk arbitrage, is a strategy used in the context of mergers and acquisitions. Let's say company A announces plan to acquire company B. The stock price of company B typically rises, but it might not fully reflect the acquisition price until the deal is finalized. As an arbitrager, you could buy company B's stock at its current price, expecting it to rise closer to the acquisition price once the deal is completed, thereby making a profit. Number 5. Currency arbitrage. Currency arbitrage involves exploiting differences in exchange rates in different markets. Imagine the exchange rate for US dollar to euro is 1.0.85 in one market and 1.0.88 in another. You could convert your dollars to euros in the market with the lower exchange rate, then convert them back in the market with the higher rate, ending up with more dollars than you started with due to exchange rate differences. So now, who can use arbitrage strategy? Arbitrage isn't just for traders. It's also a valuable tool for strategic decision making in business. Companies can use arbitrage to optimize resource allocation, pricing strategies, and even expansion plans. For example, a multinational corporation might leverage labor cost differentials between countries to establish manufacturing plants in locations where production costs are lower, thus improving profitability. In conclusion, arbitrage strategy is a powerful concept in strategic management, offering opportunities for profit and optimization in various contexts. By understanding the fundamentals of arbitrage and staying informed about market dynamics, individuals and organizations can harness its potential to achieve their strategic objectives.